Alright, I'm just going to make a quick video of this nav I got on eBay. Well, let me turn the phone sideways real quick. Hopefully that doesn't screw up the video and makes it easier to see. If not, I'll redo one later. Anyway, I got it in. I haven't calibrated the screen yet or anything like that. But you can see 82 degrees Fahrenheit. It's got the temperature up there. Nav, Wi-Fi, I should say, time. Is the time even current? I'm not even sure. I think the time's current. It's got to be. It's on GPS. And where the hell is my flash on? I don't know how to turn the flash off on this freaking phone. But anyway, we'll come over here from the side. Right here we got nav. I do not have the antenna hooked up, and I'll get to that why and the reason in a minute. But it's Google Maps, unless you download some other type of app. I think that's where you can download apps. Yeah, you can download, install. I haven't really played with it yet. We'll just hit exit. Bluetooth, I haven't messed with it. Car record, no idea what that is. I guess it records dash cam or something. I haven't had a time. And it did not come with an instruction manual, so I don't really know. But anyway, I got the auxiliary input connected. Oh, it's not going to work because the camera's on and it's connected to my phone. But anyways, let's go back home. You can go to settings, Wi-Fi. As you can see, I am connected to the mobile hotspot on my iPhone. But let's go back. Bluetooth. And it scrolls just like your phone. It's honestly for $370 or whatever I paid, $360, I can't even remember. I'll post it up. I am extremely surprised at the quality. Let's go to the internet. We haven't tried this yet. Oh yeah, Google. So let's Google. We'll just share location, okay. We'll go Duramax Forms. So D-U-R-A-M-A-X space form. Click it. And bam, look at that, Duramax form. Alright guys, anyways, that's 2.5 minutes of video. That should be plenty for now. I'll get some more videos and some more reviews and all that later. But yes, awesome buy. And the fitment. Oh, the fitment is almost absolutely perfect. You gotta fight the wires and the little adapter box for the steering wheel controls, which steering wheel controls, as you can hear, it's beeping. As you can see, steering wheel controls do work. Source, it changes it up at the top. I do not have the GPS antenna hooked up because in this little gap right here, it'll go away. I just didn't want to fight it anymore. I just threw it in to check it real quick. Basically, I got a pinched wire, and I know I do. I just didn't mess with it just because I wanted to hurry up and get a video. I was too anxious. But anyway, GPS antenna, let's go to that. I threw all my wires. It does come with some remote I'll never use, but GPS antenna. Somewhere in here. There we go. GPS antenna. I'm going to spend more time. I didn't have time tonight. I just got off work. It's 9 o'clock. I've been building decks all day and dealing with a mess of a staircase. But anyway, this little guy, I plan on mounting it right up there somewhere, running the wire along and down the pillar and back behind the dash. Clearly there's plenty of cable to do it properly. Like I said, it was on my porch when I got home and I wanted to hurry up and put it in. Anyways, AMS, I have no idea what that is. Nothing, who knows. But anyway, yeah, GPS antenna, that the reason it's not mounted is because I ran out of time and I'm gonna do it properly. And the reason also I didn't want to spend time, I gotta pull this thing back out. Unfortunately, it came with, well, if you've got, I've got a 2011 LML, LTZ. And I've got this little guy down here in my center console, USB hookup. In order to hook that up to the car, or to this new stereo headset, it came with the feed that plugs in the back of the factory radio is this little plug right here. In the back of this head unit, we have got a this guy, but male or something, I can't remember. I've got to take it back apart. Anyway, I got to get an adapter that's female of this guy to mail of some other type of USB connection. I can't remember. Actually, yeah, I can. Yeah, it is. So it's, I need female of this little guy to connect to the factory harness, and then I need male of the bigger regular USB, because this will plug right in the back of the head unit, and as you can see, I've got that little guy has a mic, and then I've got two USB inputs. So yeah, that'll hook up this guy right here to the factory stereo like it is from the factory. Other than that, speaker, I'm not sure what that is. I hadn't put it in yet. Came with all kinds of iPod adapter for who the hell has an old school iPod anymore, I don't know. GPS antenna, yeah, that's the USB. Oh, these guys are auxiliary video in. I don't know if you hook up a DVD player. There's more behind the dash too. I did install some of them. But anyway, back to the radio. The other thing, I need an antenna adapter. I will post which adapter it is. The factory harness antenna did not plug and play into the back of the radio. I will be getting the antenna adapter. I'm gonna actually, as soon as I get inside and after I post this, I'll order it. If I don't do it tonight, I'll post later on once I get this thing all squared away and working 100%. I'll do another nice long video. And also go over all the parts required that it did not come with. But yes, this is how you see it plug and play straight out of the box. Like I said, I just need that little USB adapter to make the USB switch in the center console work, and then I need the antenna adapter for the radio antenna. Otherwise, I just got this nonsense, and it's just straight fuzz. Also, I'll mention, look at this, check this out. Oh yeah, it's just like a. Well, you can't do it on the radio, but it's just like your phone screen. It's exactly as advertised. Other than that, I am extremely happy, and I was about to spend $1,500 or something like that with the dealer to get them. I wasn't gonna go with the dealer. I've got some car knowledge. I got some scan tools and GM Tech 2, and I can't remember the other one off the top of my head. I can do some coding and programming myself, but I was gonna retrofit the factory nav, but I did not. I went with this one because it's more updated anyways. This should keep me happy for a while until I decide to upgrade to a 2015, even though I just bought this 2011 a few months ago, actually from another forum member here on Duramax forum. But anyway, we'll get to some more details later on, and that'll be that. Also, I got, I don't know why I got the video, this damn park assist blocked sea owner's manual. I got that bullshit happening all the time. Sometimes it went away. Sometimes it works, sometimes it's not. This little light flashes. Is it fixed? I don't know. Sometimes it fixes itself, sometimes it doesn't. Reverse cam. As you can see, I got the factory reverse cam up there in the mirror. Reverse down here. It will display. I will probably hide another reverse camera somewhere eventually and run wires to it. I also might hide a little, basically a reverse camera in the grill, because you can go, shit. Or maybe a dash cam or something. I think that's what car records for. I remember seeing the setting somewhere you can put another camera up on here, which I thought was pretty cool. Maybe I'll add some infrared, LEDs that project heavily up front behind all the grill where you can't see and run a camera, so it's like night vision. I did that on one of my rifles, infrared flashlight with a camera and a camera scope mount, so I can see at night, hunt at night or whatever, just target shoot at night. But anyway, we'll get to this later. I'm tired.